Hey there, CPO here. And real quick, I wanted to take a minute to go over one of the replacement parts that I got for my Taro 450 Pro V2 heli. This is my heli in its current condition after a crash, which took out the motor, the main gear. And so while I have this thing apart, I did want to take an opportunity to look at something I've been eyeballing for a while. And that is this, the one piece bearing main block assembly with the little hinge for the servos. So this is a little bit more work than I need to do for the crash. But while I have the side panel off to replace, I've got to replace some gears in here. And of course I have to replace the motor, the main shaft, redo the pinion mesh, which means I'm gonna have to do something with these servos so I can get down in there and take care of the pinion mesh. I thought it would be a good time to go ahead and try checking out this particular part. So I'm gonna do a little bit of a review here. I'll show you a little bit about the product. I don't really need to put it in. My main blocks are fine. As a matter of fact, it's gonna be a lot more work to put it in than if I don't put it in. But I really am interested in seeing exactly how it works in the heli. What benefits does it provide me? What type of access does it give me that I don't have? And mostly just want to show you guys a little bit about it, because I've been very curious and I know some of you are as well. So let's take a look at this thing first before I actually start putting it into the helicopter. So this, like I said, is a one-piece main shaft mount. In the fact that both of the bearing blocks, the main bearing blocks, the top and the lower, are connected into one piece. This is a Taro product. You can see right there it says Taro 450 Pro V2. Comes with both of the bearings, the upper and lower bearing. And it's got this little swivel arm here that hinges the servos. And the theory is that the front two servos, the cyclic servos, can mount right here. And then you can swing it up, adjust the arms, and then make it easier for arm adjustments, and then swing it back into place. I'm actually kind of curious if it gives me any benefit in actually getting to a visibility into the pinion mesh on the motor. I'm not sure if it will or not. I do have this little hinge screw here, so I'm thinking that if I unscrew that, I could pull this whole assembly up and out of the way, take care of my mesh, put the assembly back in, and then tighten it back down again. We'll see if there's any value in that or not. It really sucks to think about having to take out these two servos, which are nicely set in there, perfectly aligned, 90'd. I have everything leveled with the swash. I've got to pull those out to get access to set my pinion mesh. And even though I have to change the motor for this crash, but if I didn't have to change the motor, just in changing the main gear, which is a fairly common crash part, I'd still have to take a look at the pinion mesh to make sure that that particular main gear was in good mesh contact with the pinion. So it just kind of stinks. You get these things all locked into place and then to have to remove them. So I think there might be some benefit in being able to pull them out as a unit. At least they are attached together, and removing the servos, because there's a little bit of play when you screw down these servos, a little bit of side to side play. So you know, you can pretty much lock that down here and then just move out this whole assembly, and I think that's the benefit there. But I don't know if the pivoting capability will give me much with regard to what I'm trying to do. The other thing that I want to point out is it does have this cutout for the rear servo, and I don't know, you can see that right there. It looks like the rear servo kind of sets inside this block and then fastens in. That's different than the standard main blocks where it would just fasten onto the outside. So what I'm curious there is, number one, I'm going to have to change my servo position. The center servo, I had to move to the right side of the heli because I actually knocked the screw head off. I'll have to move it back to the left side of the heli because this only has a left side servo mount. which is the traditional location for the rear servo, so it's not that big of a deal. It's more work for me to put this in, but for most people, if, especially if you're doing this as part of an upgrade when you build, or if you have to take the whole thing apart anyway, it's not that big of a deal. But at any rate, so that's going to be interesting. The other thing is it's inset more, I'm assuming, into the center, so I'm wondering how it makes the servo arm placement, because the standard configuration has the ball directly in the center line of the helicopter, and if you inset the servo, that's going to change things. So maybe the ball goes on the other side of the arm. I don't know. I'll play with it, figure it out, and I'll show you what I come up with. But that's that. I'll check it out for you. Let you know what I think. So other than this cool little hinged servo mount, why do people like the one-piece main shaft bearing mounts? Quite frankly, it's because the idea that it would reduce tendency for vibration. When you have separate bearing blocks, they have to be perfectly aligned for the main shaft to go in and get perfectly aligned. And if there's any variance, any frame flex, for example, during hard flying or during the build process, if things weren't perfectly aligned, you might have a little bit of misalignment between the two bearing blocks, which could result in some vibration. So the thought here is that because these are it's a one-piece unit, these two bearings are aligned right off the get-go, so it reduces the chances for vibration. I don't particularly have any problems with my main shaft. Any vibration in the head, I use the Robur G31 fly barless system, and it's got a vibration log in it that tells me if I have any vibration in both the main shaft and the tail. And I don't have any significant vibration, so I'm not putting this in to reduce vibration, but that's a very common reason people would go to a mount like this. So at any rate, I'm going to put it in, check it out, and I'll tell you what I think. All right, so for those of you that are counting calories with your helicopters and are on the Weight Watchers program, let's see how these two different bearing block assemblies weigh in. So this is the factory Taro bearing blocks weighing at 20 grams. And then the one-piece bearing block with the swivel mount for the servos weighs in at a whopping 20 grams. So essentially, these end up weighing the same thing. So if weight is a consideration for you, you can rule that out of your equation. All right, so one thing that's notable about this one-piece bearing block assembly, as you can see, I have the front servos in there, which is nice. They would basically swivel up out of the way, or with the removal of one screw, the whole assembly would come off. And I'll show you that after I get this mounted onto the frame, so you can kind of see how that works. But in mounting the rear servo, there's a little bit of a challenge in that it's a slightly different design than you might have had with the previous bearing block. Let me grab that other bearing block here. So with the standard mounting of the rear servo against that outside of the bearing block, it basically puts it with a standard servo arm and ball, puts the ball at the center line of the helicopter, which is where you want it. However, when we look at this other bearing block, you can see that it's got a recess for the servos. So when you put the servo inside the block, your ball is now no longer lined up with the center line. So it's not a problem, it just means you have to rethink how you mount this. As you can see, moving the servo in brings it closer to the middle of the helicopter, which actually I'm assuming is expected to bring the center of gravity closer in. But either way, it just means we have to change the way we do things. So if you take this standard ball and flip it, to the other side of the arm, which seems to be the common solution for this. And assuming you have a servo that you can do this with. So it's my understanding not all servos have the clearance to allow the ball to be reversed. And as you can see, eventually I get to a point where I hit the servo with the ball. So we'll have to figure out once I get things going how low I can have that go. I'm assuming it's not going to be that low, so I'm probably going to be okay. But at any rate, when you flip the ball, it does get it much better aligned with the center line, but now it's a little bit too far to this side of the center line, and that kind of bugs me. Not by far, just a couple millimeters. This is a standard standoff ball. So the next thing I did is look at a flush mount ball and how that changes things. And it turns out the flush mount ball is really going to be the best option. And again, you're going to want to put the ball on the backside or the underside of the servo arm towards the servo itself. But the flush mount ball gets it even closer to center. And as you can see now, pretty darn close. I mean, it may not be exactly on the center line, but it's close enough for this application. And I think that really is the best solution. As a matter of fact, if you sight down, there you go, you can sight down the center line. It's pretty darn, it might even be exactly there. So that's the solution for this rear servo, is to get a flush mount ball with no standoff. But that's what the solution is for this rear servo. I don't know if everybody has these flush mount balls laying around. I actually stole this off of a tail control bearing from the pitch slider. You know, I'm pretty sure Dave's going to start stocking these at terrorchelly.com. Anyway, so this is probably what you want to get along with this bearing mount. So at any rate, I just wanted to go through that with you. I'm going to finish mounting up these servos, wanted to make sure I showed you what you need to do to get this ball realigned with the center point with this particular style of bearing block. All right, so this is my heli. I'm just about rebuilt, ready to go. The only thing I have left to do is put the tail boom on. But I have all these servos set up, 90'd. I got the swash all leveled, everything like that. And now what I want to do is set my pinion mesh to the main gear. And I need to be able to get underneath these servos to do that. So I saved that for last because I wanted to see how effective this tip-up servo mount was going to be for getting actually work done. There are a couple of things that it's supposed to be a benefit for. One of them being to be able to change servo arms easily without having to undo everything, and then also to be able to get to perhaps underneath to the motor. So as you can see the pinion when you tip it down. I can actually get some get a driver down in here if I had to loosen that up and make a quick adjustment. Not ideal. I really can't see the mesh. It's still underneath the servos. Tipping it up gets me a better view of what's happening down there, but doesn't give me much more access. So really what you're going to have to do is just unpivot this, and there's a simple screw right here that holds this together. And once you pop that out, now your servo assembly is free. To be done, do whatever you want with it, basically. You can pull it out of the way, change servo arms. I can get to the pinion mesh, and I'm going to take care of that here in a minute. Don't know if you can see, a little side note, I do have a helical cut main gear and pinion that I'm trying out this time around. So kind of excited about that. It's supposed to be quite a bit quieter and more efficient, so we'll see. So with this, I can pop that out without having to undo my servos, right? You can see how I have my servo wires running between the servos and then popping out the front here. All of that can stay in place. And then when I'm done, I can basically just reaffix this one pivot screw. Just like that. Tighten that down, don't forget thread locker, and then put in your two screws on each side, top and bottom, to actually hold the entire thing in place. And then you're back into business. So really, you're removing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 screws, but you're not messing with your alignment. So I've intentionally not put my head on completely yet, because I level the swash, and then I'm going to take this servo mounting bracket out. And then I'm going to, you know, do my adjustments on the pinion. Then I'm going to put it back together, and then I want to check the swash level. So if this thing goes back exactly the way it came, you know, it was before, then my swash should be perfectly level, and I would feel comfortable removing this assembly without having to recheck any settings. You know, if you start removing servos, you know, you start tweaking with adjustments and things like that. So that's kind of the benefit here. It is really nice and easy, simple. Another huge benefit I like is the fact that this main shaft is captured in that, which means I don't have to worry about my wires running against the main shaft. They can lay up against this all day long. It doesn't hurt anything. You know, I still have to worry about them getting back here with this rear servo arm, but not really a big deal the way I have it set up. So that's kind of cool too. So I think it's neat. And like I said, I'll go back in and check my swash leveling after I put it back together, and I'll let you know how it works out. All right, so just as I promised, put everything back together. Got my pinion mesh set up. Got all that working good. Put the servos back down, tighten them up, put the swash back on, check swash level, dead on, just like it was before I took it all apart. So totally cool that you can... you know, just pop these things out as a unit without having to worry about anything getting out of adjustment. And then, like I said, you can have, you know, wires run past this this center column here because it's protected, you know. And then just make sure your wires stay clear of that center servo, and everything will be good. So, anyway, highly recommend it, and thanks for watching.